In this video, I'm showing you 3 custom tools and appliances I designed to improve our lives as LEGO builders, kindly sponsored by Bambu Lab. Not sure if you've seen that video, but last month I showed how I designed the perfect LEGO sorting system. And I mean perfect! Making the best out of IKEA Alex cabinet drawers I use to sort my LEGO, I made special inserts that use every millimeter of space available, including the not so easily accessible deep end of the drawer, while also matching the sizes of LEGO pieces in a mix and match fashion where you can customize the sorting trays to your liking and needs. The feedback has been overwhelmingly positive, and I see that a lot of you are already printing your own inserts, which is amazing. Somebody suggested that I should design a lid for easier and safer transportation, which I really liked. Putting my A1 printer to work, I quickly designed a simple lid that fits the larger trays, which in turn now makes this system accessible to people who don't even have Alex drawers, but would like to store their LEGO like this, which is awesome. So before moving on to the tools themselves, I have to explain how all of this is possible thanks to today's video sponsor Bambu Lab. Bambu Lab is a 3D printer brand that amongst many of their products sells the A1 and the A1 Mini printers, entry-level products both in price and accessibility to first-time users. Like, for real, I had no 3D printing experience prior to testing this out, but after unboxing the A1 Mini as an example, tightening some screws, letting the printer run auto-calibration tests for 15 minutes, and placing a roll of filament, I was making my very first prints just like that. The A1 printer that comes with a larger print plate required some assembling, which was completely fine, and after the same kind of auto-calibration tests, it was ready to print as well. The app makes it very easy to push a button and start prints just like that, as all the settings are automatically dialed in. It was really easy to get started as a complete beginner, and I for one have been playing around with these a lot more than I have with LEGO, but don't say anyone. And that's where the topic of the video comes into play. When building LEGO on a table or desk, sometimes I need to put the bricks away, and that's probably easier said than done, especially for the small pieces that run everywhere. To address that issue, I made this tool, introducing the LEGO Scooper. While it may not look like much, I found it to be incredibly faster at picking a piece from a flat surface. To make sure of that, I timed myself picking pieces by hand, and then picking the same pieces using the LEGO Scooper. The numbers don't lie, and especially when it came down to the very small bits that you usually end up picking up one by one, the LEGO Scooper made my life incredibly easier. Next up, I wanted to address an issue where, when building LEGO sets and opening the bags to dump the pieces, once again, pieces will run everywhere. Mixing things of the larger and the smaller bags makes building less optimal, not to mention that when you're doing a large LEGO set, desks seem to be way too small to hold the pieces, the build and the building instructions, so to keep things tidy and organized, I developed a modular tray system to organize LEGO pieces. Usually, when you open a new numbered bag, you'll oftentimes find either one or two smaller bags of pieces inside of the larger pieces bag. So with these trays, I designed a module to hold the larger pieces, and then a two-section module that holds each of the individual bags of pieces, making things much tidier. As you're probably noticing, there's this slot in here which makes connect the modules possible, and since I gave all modules zero tolerance space, while the feet will be hard to put together, when put together using a bit of force will make the combo flow almost seamlessly, which my minimalistic mind loves. To give people some options, because maybe they won't be using this for building sets and rather use it for custom builds or even things outside of LEGO, I designed a single narrower module that, like the previous one, as connection points for a seamless design. You can 3D print multiples of each of the modules to make your own optimal tray, and when you're happy with the result, just finish things off with these end modules for a super clean look. LEGO building will never be the same. The final tool gave me a lot more headaches than I care to admit, but it was totally worth it. Have you ever seen that LEGO ruler, triangular shaped and very useful for LEGO measurements? Unfortunately, it's a retired product you cannot find in stores anymore. And if you head over to Bricklink to purchase one, you'll quickly realize that the prices for them are kind of insane. So you can kinda guess where this is going, right? I made one myself, heavily inspired on the LEGO one. I was really proud of my first design, even using using the multicolored printing abilities of the AMS light system Bambu Lab sent for both printers, which are just add-ons not required to get the basic printers running. But my measurements were all wrong, I couldn't place it on top of studs, and the slot I designed in the middle didn't fit plates as I intended it to, so back to the drawing board. The second design was a major improvement over those issues, the teeth finally fit between LEGO studs, the slot in the middle finally fit LEGO plates, and I even included a ruler on the other side to measure how many bricks tall things are. But there were two major issues. I decided to engrave the numbers for the brick stall ruler, but you hardly notice them, which I didn't like. But the biggest issue of them all was that when placing the studs ruler on top of the studs, the numbers were upside down, which was a big fail. Back to the drawing board. After all those issues were addressed, I thought I had finally cracked the code with version 3, but for some reason the 4s were all messed up. But with all of that finally fixed and out of the way, I present to you the LEGO ruler. It does everything the official ruler did, but in a more compact form factor. It measures studs up to 16, it measures how tall in bricks a build is, but what I'm most proud of is the slot in the middle, because since it is aligned with the studs measuring numbers, that means you can place any 1x plates to know how big they are. Tiles, Technic beams, axles, LEGO bars, and more. That's cool, right? I for one am very proud of it, and with the AMS allowing you to switch colors around, means you can do this in other color combos like black on white, white on gray, classic space, or even Blacktron. You will be able to find all of these designs on Maker World for free, so be sure to like, download, and print the heck out of them. Bambu Lab is also running their Black Friday sales for a couple more days, so if you ever thought about getting a 3D printer, Bambu Lab is my absolute top recommendation for you if you are a complete beginner. They are incredibly easy and intuitive to use to first-time users. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all on the next one.